The targeting for this attack was done with detailed knowledge of the process and its dependencies. The hits were extremely precise. The Yemeni armed forces claimed it attacked the facility with 10 drones, or cruise missiles. But the hits on these targets look like neither. A total of 17 hits with such precise targeting lets me assume that these were some kind of drones or missiles with man-in-the-loop control. They may have been launched from within Saudi Arabia. The US and Israel are able to commit such attacks. Iran probably too. Yemen seems unlikely to have this capability without drawing on extensive support from elsewhere. Middle East Eye, a Qatari-financed outlet, reported yesterday that the attack was launched from Iraq by Iran-aligned forces in revenge for Israeli attacks in Syria. The author, David Hearst, is known for slandered reporting. The report is based on a single anonymous Iraqi intelligence source. Qatar, which is struggling with Saudi Arabia and the United Arab Emirates over its support for the Muslim Brotherhood, would like to see a larger conflict involving its rivals east and west of the Persian Gulf. Something does not add up. Why is the US ignoring the people who claimed fault? They know that Iran is helping the Houthis. So what? The US has supported their proxies from the days of the pioneers being paid for every dead Indian to supplying ISIS with new Toyotas. Wouldn't they be attacking tanks in the refinery that were full of oil and gas rather than empty ones? A bit too convenient. Why does Fred Flintstone, Pompeo, jump to conclusions about evidence when there is none? It seems a bit too obvious who is really behind this electioneering anyone. Notice a pattern here, guys. First the tanker wars, 3 attacks. When Iran responded, that stopped. Just a while after, now this. Whosoever is behind this wants a war very badly. My money is on the bankers. All wars are bankers' wars after all. Just to keep in mind, if missiles were launched from Iran, they would have had to cross the Persian Gulf, pretty much over Bahrain, where the US 6th Fleet is headquartered, over Dammam, and strike the target, all while undetected by the vast area of assets the US has in the region, let alone Saudi Arabia's defenses. This is attributing to Iran's stealth missiles with pinpoint accuracy that the most modern US radar defenses absolutely cannot detect, entirely invisible. Even the tail burn. Does that make sense? And if it is true, do you really want to start a war against whoever has that technology? I mean, the US mainland is far less protected than that area of the world. How many nuclear plants are within 100 miles of the ocean, where any frigate could launch one of these? So, we have absolutely no evidence. We have a claim made by a barbaric terror state that constantly lies and has it in for Iran. And we have the Trump lapping it up. Of course the liars in charge will never walk through the implications of their lies. They just expect you to swallow them, hook, line and sinker, and start World War III just because they tell you to. This was most likely Saudi self-inflicted. A false flag, they damage their own stuff, blame Iran, and start the war they have been dreaming of. Pretty easy to do. All they had to do is wait until Houthis launched an attack for the timing. Better to stage an attack on soon-to-be unneeded infrastructure and blame your people's ensuing financial pain on terrorism than become dog meat when they realize you squandered their birthright for pennies on the dollar, and it's gone now. This is a regime survival propaganda play. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.